Good evening, everyone. This is Bremster, and it's kind of time for me to return to a game that I played. It must have been 5 or 6 years ago, and this is Life is Strange. And this is the story game that made me start exploring other story games. This one was playable on the computer I had at the time, and I fell in love with it. I played this game, and I lost a long weekend, and I'm about to come into a long weekend, and I thought it would be a good time for me to do it again. So here is me trying to do Life is Strange. This will not be an action game. This will not be a doing builds or anything like this. This is just me going to be playing a story and making a choices and exploring the characters. Let's see if I can find the same joy I did last time. So let's go into a new game of Life is Strange. Hey Keith, hi Ratfinks. Life is Strange is a story-based game that features player choice. The consequences of all of your in-game actions and decisions will impact the past, present, and future. I didn't read it all because I was... If you enjoyed Firewatch, you are going to love this.
Where am I? What's happening? I'm trapped in a storm? How did I get here? And where is here? Wait, there's the lighthouse. I'll be safe if I can make it there. I hope. Please let me make it there.
I think I've got my mouse sensitivity set too high. Might be better. Blackwell Academy, 1910.
Come on, Max. You can make it. Holy shit.
Let me know if the audio levels are wrong.
Surreal.
Famously called film Little Pieces of Time. But he could be talking about photography, as he likely was.
Okay. I'm in class. Everything's cool. I am okay.
From light to shadow. From color to chiaroscuro. Now, can you give me an example of a photographer who perfectly captured the human condition in black and white?
I didn't fall asleep, and that sure didn't feel like a dream.
Bueller.
Weird.
Diane Arbus.
There you go, Victoria. Why Arbus?
Because of her images of hopeless faces. You feel like totally haunted by the eyes of those sad mothers and children.
She saw why are the controls tortured, not what right? I expected?
And frankly, it's bullshit. Shh, 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 shh. Keep that to yourself. Seriously, though, I could frame any one of you in a dark corner and capture you.
Oh, look at this crap. How can I show this to Mr. Jefferson? I can hear the class laughing at me now.
In a moment of desperation, And any one of you could do that to me. Isn't that too easy? Too obvious?
I can't believe I still have this pencil case. I should upgrade to the 21st century. But I like it old school.
So she could have taken another.
I haven't kept up with my journal as much as I should.
I'm not a big fan of her work.
My little camera bag is battered, but still kicking.
Me too, Victoria. He captured the essence of post-war beat America.
If anybody else looked at this, what would they think?
October 1st, October, my favorite month, the best weather of the year. I love watching the leaves change color, turning into tiny flames. But it's still too darn hot, thanks global warming, and I can't bust out the big coats and sweaters or scary movies yet. Soon, Kate let me borrow The October Country by Ray Bradbury. I haven't read much by him, which caused Warren to almost revoke my geek cred before I held up my copy of Battle Royale, but he nails the autumn atmosphere of small towns. The last time I wore a Halloween costume was with Chloe. I have pictures in one of my old albums. I should find a real Halloween party to crash so I can experience some social mingling. It's that, or a Vortex Club Stroke Fest swimming party. Or is that Backstroke Fest? You're so punny, Max. At least I'm trying to climb out of my cocoon. I shouldn't expect my life to completely change after a few weeks of Blackwell Academy, as my parents love telling me on a loop, you have all the time in the world. July 10th, 2013. I got accepted into Blackwell Academy. So this is going... It's October 1st. Holy cow. I got accepted into Blackwell Academy. If words could dance, this world would be a rave, even though I've never been to one. But who cares, because I got into Blackwell Academy. I didn't think I would be so excited, since it's not like I didn't used to live in the same town. But when I saw the text from Blackwell's scholarship office, I could literally feel my pulse speed up. I thought it was going to say, sorry, thanks for playing. It took me a few seconds before I read the whole thing. I guess I wanted to enjoy that last moment of blissful ignorance. And when I saw the first word, congratulations, I think I screamed. My mum cried and my dad laughed. They're so weird. But they're happy, and this means extra financial support because they don't have to pay anything to Blackwell. This means new clothes, and if I can work it, a new laptop. Oh, and I have to keep telling myself in caps that I am going to Blackwell Academy. August 18th, 2013. So this is it. I'm leaving Seattle to go back to Arcadia Bay. Usually people go to high school closest to home. I suppose I am too. It's just that I haven't lived there for 5 years. Out of all of the best photography programs in the world, I choose to go to the smallest, back in a town I was excited about leaving. Maybe I wanted to come back all along, just to see if Chloe and I are still even friends. But I do wish Chloe could have moved with us to Seattle. That city was made for her. When we would play pirates in our rooms and in the woods, it seemed like Seattle was that fabled faraway island of treasure and adventure that we were always seeking. With coffee shops. But Seattle wasn't like a fable. Au contraire, now Blackwell Academy seems more exotic to me than any other place in the world. To study photography under Mark Jefferson, sigh. Insert hearts and flowers. Plus there will be cool, diverse students from everywhere. It won't be like my high school now. I never really found a groove with my classmates, or boys. I'm lucky I have a couple of great friends here, but it's time to ship out. So maybe Arcadia Bay will actually turn out to be the island of treasure and adventure I've been looking for. I'm going to check my microphone levels, which will mean closing out of the game a little. Where's OBS? OBS is there. The microphone level seems to be good. We'll see how it goes. August 25th. Shit is crazy here. I didn't realize how much crap I had to pack until I had to pack all my crap. Mum and Dad are getting a little too excited. I'm clearing out my room, though I caught Mum crying when she was packing my shirts. That made me want to cry like a little girl and never leave Seattle. So instead of packing, I feel like burning all my clothes and then just raiding a thrift store to build up a new Max wardrobe over my junior year. Not that I even have an old Max wardrobe. Nobody will know me except for Chloe, and who knows how different we are now. So I can cut my hair, get a tat and some piercings, maybe date a cute foreign exchange artiste from Paris or Rome. I can do anything, unless I get busted. And there will be so many super cool chances for my photography to get exposed. Thinking about that is when I get scared, but excited. And then I don't feel like crying at all. I get tingles down my arms, sensing the universe opening up for me. I can't wait to leave. But I just want things to be different at Blackwell. September 2nd, 2013, 12:07 a.m. My first entry from my new dorm room the night before my first day at Blackwell. Phew. I haven't had any time to write or even take pictures since I got here. My shit is in boxes all over the room, which is small but mine, and I never want to leave. I can't wait to decorate. I plan a whole wall of photos. I did meet some of my dorm mates, though I suck at remembering names, so I won't bother right now. But I think I can already see who's going to be cool to me and who's not. It's a bitch trying to get settled into a new school and social scene after I finally found good friends in Seattle. But I'm here now, and this is the start of my new life. Sweet dreams. September 3rd, 2013. Blackwell sucks ass. I told myself not to whine so soon, but damn, the day started like Christmas morning. I barely had any dreams because I was so pumped to start my first official day of my new life. Like a dork, I couldn't figure out what to wear, so I chose what I was on the floor. I'm no good with names and faces right away, but I picked up some names like Kate Brooke Taylor Alyssa. And how could I forget Victoria Chase? Rich, stylish, entitled. I could feel instant judgment when she looked at my raggedy-ass clothes, as if I'm at Blackwell to strike fashion poses. Maybe I'm being extra crispy sensitive, but I think Victoria wants life here to be like her own reality show. Ugh. So that wasn't fun along with my general social unease. I thought it would be easier being back. Call the wambulance. I don't want this day to end all woe is Max. It was incredible to walk across the green campus in the morning mist. I loved the stone steps and brick walls of Blackwell. Everything is a picture waiting to be taken. Speaking of, at least one great thing did happen today. Mr. Jefferson's photography class. Sigh. There's more to tell, journal. Forgive me. I'm truly wiped out. September 4th. I have an arseload of homework already. So much bullshit. At least give us noobs a day to acclimate. But to prove I'm not a total loser, I made a new friend in my science class. His name is Warren Graham, and he's a serious geek. Plus, he's dark and witty. He comes across as kind of a know-it-all, but it turns out he does kind of know a lot. We talk about photographers, and he actually named a few I'd never heard of. We traded numbers, and he'd be a good study partner, or a good friend. I'll need at least one based on the clique action here. I thought being 18 meant I didn't have to deal with this teenage drama anymore. I thought. At least I get to research famous photographers for some of my homework. Mr. Jefferson assigned us a ton of reading, but this is exactly what I want to study. Jefferson is super cool and super chill. He doesn't try to be too hip, just says what he thinks and expects us to as well. I think he's a genius. Oh my god, I want to marry him. Just joking. This one class is worth all the social dysfunction. September 15th. Homework is kicking my ass. I'll bet the teachers grade harder just to stop you from feeling special. But Victoria Chase and her snob minions still front like they are honored guests of Blackwell. The bros here aren't that different. Nathan Prescott is Victoria's male clone, with way more money and attitude, if that's possible. His family is the oldest in Arcadia Bay, and I heard stories about them when I was a kid. The Prescotts give a shitload of bank to Blackwell, so Nathan acts like he literally owns the school. Yesterday during class, he put his feet on the desk, started texting, and the teacher didn't say jack. I'd get suspended, but him and Victoria are part of this silly elite vortex club that puts on popular parties, and so they get their way. It's good to be the king and queen. I don't want to slam everybody. I do like Kate Marsh. She's down the hall in one of my classes. She's so pretty and sweet and friendly. It makes her more beautiful than the biatches here like Victoria who think beauty is just your face and outfit. See, I'm already playing their drama games. No more. September 23rd. Finally had a chance to take some actual shots around campus today. A perfect blue sky day. I always forget how great I feel after I take pictures when I've been slacking off. Speaking of pictures, Mr. Jefferson told us about the National Everyday Heroes photo contest he wants us all to enter. The winner gets a trip to San Francisco and lots of publicity. He wants just one photograph from each student. This is exactly why I wanted to come to Blackwell, and of course I'm scared shitless to enter. At least I have a couple weeks before the deadline in October, so I have plenty of time to stress and procrastinate. Sigh. September 30th. I don't know whether I love it or hate it here. I'm trying to keep up with my science class of all things, like I give a shit or even understand it. Good thing I know Warren. Too bad I can't clone him to take my place in class. Ms. Grant is much cooler than the class. She explains particle physics so even boneheads like me can kinda understand. I love how she relates society to science and vice versa. I can tell she's committed and passionate about life, unlike some of us in her class, but I'm trying to engage more, even if it means asking actual questions in class instead of hiding in the back. I'm just glad I'm not the only social misfit here. Now, how much homework are you avoiding? October, my favourite month, and this is, I think, where I came in. Yeah, this is where I came in. Yep. So, right, it starts on page 8 and then it went back. So...
And there was honesty about the economic conditions of the era, but a beauty in the struggle. You don't have beauty without a beat, which explains why...
I should take a picture to prove I'm still here. Plus, it's perfect for my portfolio. And I have to get my daily selfie quota.
We've all seen that iconic shot of Kerouac on the balcony. And if you haven't, shame, shame. Capturing the romantic urban solitude of the 20th century poet. Shh. I believe Max has taken what you kids call a selfie. A dumb word for a wonderful photographic tradition. And Max has a gift. Of course, as you all know, the photo portrait has been popular since the early 1800s. Your generation was not the first to use images for selfie expression. Sorry, I couldn't resist. The point remains that portraiture has always been a vital aspect of art and photography for as long as it's been around. Now, Max, since you've captured our interest and clearly want to join the conversation, can you please tell us the name of the process that gave birth to the first self-portraits?
You're asking me? Let me think.
You either know this or not, Max. Is there anybody here who knows their stuff?
Louis Daguerre was a French painter who created daguerreotypes. A process that gave portraits a sharp reflective style, like a mirror. Now you're totally stuck in the retro zone. Sad face.
Very good, Victoria. The Daguerrean process brought out fine detail in people's faces, making them extremely popular from the 1800s onward. The first American daguerreotype self-portrait was done by Robert Cornelius. You can find out all about him in your textbook, or even online. And guys, don't forget the deadline to submit a photo in the Everyday Heroes contest. I'll fly out with the winner to San Francisco, where you'll be feted by the art world. It's great exposure, and it can kickstart a career in photography. So Stella and Alyssa, get it together. Taylor, don't hide. I'm still waiting for your entry, too. And yes, Max, I see you pretending not to see me.
Victoria doesn't wait. Even her school books are gift-wrapped. I can't believe she made fun of me in class. What is she, 15 years old? And people laughed. Of course, Victoria has to have the bestest, newest, most expensive everything. This might make a cool shot.
By putting yourself out there in the world, now, no matter who wins, this is just a bump on a bigger road. I don't want anybody to feel excluded from this process, but I also want everybody to know that this book...
Well, that's right. It's take photos of different things, and if you can get all of them, there's an achievement. I never managed to pull this off. So these are the people I've met from this chapter.
Kate looks so sad and quiet today. Poor thing. Hi, Kate.
Oh. Hi, Max.
You seem quiet today.
Just thinking too much.
I hear that. Wanna go grab a cup of tea and bitch about life?
Thanks, but not today. I have to go over homework.
No worries. Let's hang later.
Sure.
Looks like somebody was already working on this. Cool. Even in pictures, the forest around here always looks mysterious.
I'm not sure what I should be saying. I mean, I love this exploration.
You can never escape the lighthouse here.
The lighthouse is everywhere.
So cool that we can check these out anytime. The decisive moment by Henri Cartier-Bresson, that's rare. Annie Leibovitz, mad respect. The amazing Eugene Smith, good to see Avedon among the masters. Dolly, of course. Lots of people I haven't heard of yet. I guess that's why I'm here. Man, he even has the best plasma HDTV for a class monitor. Can't wait
plasma.
To watch some
wow, this is dated.
This bad boy. Every time I look at Victoria, I feel like she's talking smack about me. Excuse me. Mr. Jefferson, can I talk to you for a moment?
Yes. Excuse you.
No, Victoria. Excuse us. I'd never let one of photography's future stars avoid handing in her picture.
I didn't have any time. Way too much homework.
Max, you're a better photographer than a liar. Now, I know it's a drag to hear some old dude lecture you, but life won't wait for you to play catch-up. You're young, the world is yours, blah, 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 right? But you do have a gift. You have the fever to take images, to frame the world only the way you envision it. Now, all you need is the courage to share your gift with others. And that's what separates the artist from the amateur.
You didn't tell me how cute I looked yet.
I was about to.
I'm not paying on
you.
Welcome to the real world.
Just cute?
Hot.
Then I might send you a special picture. They're just getting you ready.
I'm starting to remember some of these people. Oh my god, this game must have been.
I need a serious timeout in the bathroom. Splash water on my face and make sure I don't look like a total loser.
I hate that class. It's so fucking boring.
Frappy, I'm not going to spoil anything.
She's so fucking shy.
I do remember things about this game. And I do remember some of the special secrets about the characters. But I've also heard it said that you want to play this game again because you will, particularly after a period of time, make different choices. And those different choices will lead to different things. This game also has one of the best game soundtracks I've ever encountered. I listen to the soundtrack of this game quite regularly.
To all of you, American girls inside too, imagine a world without you.
These missing persons posters are popping up everywhere.
Be part of the world around you. Driving a car by the seaside, watching the world from the bright side.
I shouldn't be so stingy with my blood. I hate having everybody see inside my locker.
American girls in the
I love that picture of mom and dad. Hello, Jack. Kiss, kiss. Andy, you look totally fabulous, as usual.
With shiny smiles and plastic bunnies. I wish I had.
Wow, I'm remembering some of these people.
Girlfriend.
Dana is on my floor, too. She's such an archetypal, gorgeous cheerleader. They must make them in a factory. I shouldn't be so catty. Dana is nice to me. That's Dana talking to... I think his name is Justin. I've seen Brooke hanging out with Warren. She seems like his type.
I hate boy jockstraps like Logan. And he's a Vortex Club member. Poor Daniel, he's so nice. I wish I could beat the shit out of Logan. I wish October would last forever.
Yeah, they are everywhere.
It looks like she's been gone for months.
So I'm hoping to work through all of the Life is Strange games, and I know some of them are about events that come up in this, and this is, like, freaking me out.
Don't need a PC. Missed the Poetry Jam tryouts, and I did not steal that backpack. That's so messed up. I should contact them to find out what I can do. As if I am.
I hope you're all here and ready for this.
50. Good. Nobody can see my meltdown, except for me.
This is a good time to like and subscribe because things may change, or like the stream because you may get a little distracted soon.
Now, who would bother to write that crap? Just relax. Stop torturing yourself. You have a gift. Fuck it. When a door closes, a window opens. Or something like that. Okay, girl, you don't get a photo op like this every day.
It's cool, Nathan. Don't stress. You're okay, bro. Just count to three. Don't be scared. You own this school. If I wanted, I could blow it up. You're the boss. So what do you want?
I hope you check the perimeter, as my step-ass would say. Now, let's talk business.
I got nothing for you.
Wrong. You got hella cash.
That's my family, not me.
Oh, boo-hoo, poor little rich kid. I know you've been pumping drugs and shit to kids around here. I bet your respectable family would help me out if I went to them. Man, I can see the headlines now.
Leave them out of this, bitch!
I can tell everybody Nathan Prescott is a punk ass who begs like a little girl and talks to himself!
You don't know who the fuck I am or who you're messing around with!
Where'd you get that? What are you doing? Come on, put that thing down!
Don't ever tell me what to do! I'm so sick of people trying to control me!
You are going to get in hella more trouble for this than drugs.
Nobody would ever even miss your punk ass, would they?
Get that gun away from me, psycho! No!
Whoa. What the fuck? How can that be? I was in the bathroom. He shot that poor girl. I held up my hand. And then I was back here.
These pieces of time can frame us.
I already heard this lecture.
From light to shadow. From color.
Now Kate is being hassled again. And if Victoria's phone rings, this is real.
Now. Shit!
Can you give me an example of a photographer
I cannot believe who perfectly
this. Captured the human condition in black and white?
Okay, if I'm crazy, anybody? I might as well go all the way.
Bueller?
Diane.
Can I actually reverse time?
There you go, Victoria. Why Arbus?
I did it.
Can you give me an example of a photographer who perfectly captured the human condition in black and white? Anybody? Bueller?
Max, don't freak out. Not yet.
There you go, Victoria. Why Arbus?
Because of her images of hopeless faces. You feel like totally haunted by
the eyes of those sad men. When I took my selfie, Jefferson asked me a question.
She saw humanity as
if he does again, I'll know this is for real.
Kids call a selfie. A dumb word for a wonderful photographic tradition. And Max has a gift.
I know I'm not dreaming
this.
As
you all know, the
it's real.
Portrait has been popular
I can tell.
Since the early 1800s. Your generation
so I can go back in time.
For selfie expression.
What if that girl isn't dead yet?
I couldn't resist. The point
can
remains
I save
that
her?
The portraiture has always been a vital aspect of art and photography for...
I need to go to the bathroom quickly and check it out.
Now, Max, since you've captured our interest and clearly want to join the conversation, can you please... tell us the name of the process that gave birth to the first self-portraits.
I'm sorry, but I really have to use the bathroom.
Nice try, Max. But you're not gonna get away that easy. We can talk more after class. Is there anybody here
shit.
Who knows their stuff?
Jefferson wants to keep me after
Louis
class.
Was a French painter.
And I need time to save that girl.
A process that gave portraits a sharp reflective style like a mirror. Now you're totally stuck in the retro zone. Sad face.
Very good, Victoria.
What if I rewind again and give him the right answer?
Max, since you've captured our interest and clearly want to join the conversation, can you please tell us the name of the process that gave birth to the first self-portraits?
The Daguerrean process, invented by a French painter named Louis Daguerre around 1830.
Somebody has been reading as well as posing. Nice work, Max. The Daguerrean process made portraiture hugely popular, mainly because it gave the subjects clear, defined features. You can learn more when you actually finish reading the assigned chapters. Max is so far way ahead of everyone. And guys, don't forget the deadline to submit a photo in the Everyday Heroes contest. I'll fly out with the winner to San Francisco, where you'll be feted by the art world. It's great exposure, and it can kickstart a career in photography. So Stella and Alyssa, get it together. Taylor, don't hide. I'm still waiting for your entry, too. And yes, Max, I see you pretending not to see me.
Max, you are not crazy. You're not dreaming. It's time to be an everyday hero.
Nice answer, Max. Are you okay? You look pale.
Kate, did we talk at all today?
This is the first time. What's wrong?
I'm sorry, I'm just dripping. Too much stress.
I know the feeling.
I just really think Everyday Heroes is an important cultural event.
I wish we didn't. I do have to go, but we can talk later if you want.
I'll see how I feel. Thanks, Max.
No matter who wins, this is just a bump on a bigger road. I don't want anybody to feel excluded.
Do I still have the photo? I do. Okay.
From this process, but I also want everybody to know that this photographic world is not... I see you, Max Caulfield. Don't even think about leaving here until we talk about your entry. I'd never let one of photography's future stars avoid handing in her picture.
Yeah, I'm not sure I have one.
Given your selfie output, I'm sure you must have about 1,000 pics by now.
It'll take a long time to find a good one.
Max, don't wait too long. John Lennon once said that life is what happens while you're busy making other plans. Go on now. Don't let me stop you. Graphic world is not for everybody. I had my moment in the camp.
Excuse me, Mr. Jefferson, can I talk to you for a moment?
Yes, excuse you.
No, Victoria, excuse us. I'd never let one of photography's future stars avoid handing in her picture.
I'm on top of it. I think John Lennon once said that life is what happens while you're busy making other plans.
Max, you're on fire today. All the right answers, good. Make sure you finish working on it by today. I have faith in you.
I hope I have enough time to get to the bathroom. Please, please. I can't tell anybody. They'll think I'm crazy.
Yo, Daniel.
You know I don't tease.
I hate that science class with those nerds.
Okay, Max, retrace every step. I washed my face. I shredded my photo. Then the butterfly flew in. And I took a photo.
Leave them out of this, bitch!
I can tell everybody Nathan Prescott is a punk ass who begs like a little girl and talks to himself!
You don't know who the fuck I am or who you're messing around with!
Where did you get that? What are you doing? Come on, put that thing down!
Tell me what to do!
Wowzer, it's happening again.
People trying to control
me! I need a hammer to break it open.
Hella more trouble for this than drugs.
Nobody would ever even miss your punk ass, would they?
Get that gun away from me, psycho!
Oh. Holy shit, I can't let this happen. No. If I can reverse time again, I can help her.
Tell me what to do. I'm so sick of people trying to control me!
You are going to get in hella more trouble for this than drugs.
Nobody would ever even miss your punk ass, would they? No way!
Don't ever touch me again, freak!
Another shitty day.
That did not happen. This cannot be real. I just saw a girl get shot and then saved her. What the fuck is going on? Oh, do not freak out.
I love the smell of the smoke.
Oh shit, I
left my phone
in the
flask. Hey, do you hear that fire alarm? That means you should be outside.
I had to use the bathroom.
Girls always use that excuse.
Excuse for what?
For whatever you're up to. Your face is covered in guilt.
The alarm tripped me out.
Then trip on out of here, Missy. Or are you hiding something? Huh?
Thank you, Mr. Madsen. The situation is under control. There's no emergency here. Leave Miss Caulfield alone and please turn off that alarm since that's your job.
Principal Wells always looks so distracted. I can never figure out what he's thinking. Does he hate me?
You look a little stressed out. Are you okay?
I'm just a little worried about my future.
You're sweating pinballs. Is that all you're thinking about? You can always be upfront with me, Max. Or have you done something wrong? Is that it? Well, Max, talk to me.
I just got sick in class. Female trouble.
Except you're wandering around like a zombie. And do you think that's the first time a student has used that line on me?
It's the truth. I felt dizzy in Mr. Jefferson's
class. Just tell me what you're hiding. You can trust me.
There's nothing to hide. I got sick. It happens, you know.
There's that teen toot again. You know, I've heard enough. Don't think I don't know what goes on around here. You've only been here for 3 weeks, and you're already causing conflict. I don't think your parents will approve when they find out. Now get outside with class. Please.
No, he does not buy that at all. I may have just flushed my scholarship down the toilet. Yes, I could rewind and actually tell him the truth.
I'm pretty certain last time I told him the truth, so I'm doing something different this time. I don't remember for sure, but it's the sort of thing I would have done.
Hi, Miss Grant.
Excuse me, Max. I know everybody loves being asked to sign a petition, but would you do Miss Grant a favor and hear me out?
Sure, I always have time for you. What's the petition?
David Mattson, our chief of security, wants to put surveillance cameras all around the campus. Halls, classrooms, gym, dorm rooms, etc. Blackwell Academy should be a high school, not a high security penitentiary.
I guess cameras could have helped Rachel. I can see both sides.
You're fair-minded, Max. And we all pray Rachel is found safe and sound, bless her soul. But this petition isn't about her. Blackwell Academy has a noble heritage, from the Native Americans who founded this land to the pioneers who shared it in peace, not fear and violence.
Blackwell is that old? That's incredible.
You should learn a little history about your alma mater. You'll find some fascinating facts. There's a lot of power in this region. I think it helps the creative juices flow around here. Now, before I assign you homework with this lecture, will you please sign the petition to keep our campus from going back to 1984?
Absolutely. I don't mind security, but not pure surveillance.
I knew you were my favorite new student at Blackwell for a good reason.
Can you get my flash drive? I need some info and space. Hello?
Okay, I better get to my dorm and grab that flash drive. Evan's portfolio always looks so uber pro. I'd love to see his photos in there. Hey, Evan. Mind if I check out your cool portfolio?
Let's see if you're worthy of it, Max. You'll have to answer a simple question. Who photographed the famous falling soldier?
Robert Capa, of course. I love his work, despite the controversy about that photo.
My, my. This quiet child.
That was a guess.
That's why I'm here.
You're a kindred spirit, Max. Would you care for a perusal of my portfolio? It's not a privilege I grant to many.
I'd be honored, sir. These photos are great. And Rachel Amber's face is mesmerizing.
So he knew Rachel.
Come on, Logan, bring it, bro.
Yeah. Oh, I think this is the first puzzle.
I need to go to my room and return Warren's flash drive. The Prescott dormitory? Good lord, Nathan's family owns my dorm? I feel like Alyssa and I should be better friends.
Oh. Hi, Max.
What are you reading?
Love today or die forever. Don't even say anything.
Yeah.
It's a bestseller. What to say?
Good point. Now, if you'll excuse me.
Oh, look, it's Max Caulfield, the selfie hoe of Blackwell. What a lame gimmick. Even Mark, Mr. Jefferson, falls for your waif hipster bullshit. The Daguerrean process, sir. You could barely even say that. I guess you got your meds filled. Since you know all the answers, I guess you have to find another way into the dorm. We ain't moving. Oh, wait. Hold that pose. So original. Don't worry, Max. I'll put a vintage filter on it right before I post it all over social medias. Now, why don't you go fuck your selfie? Okay.
Oh, yes, Victoria. I'll get your bony ass out of my way.
The cool thing is, I don't remember any of these solutions. Yeah. Squirrel on a Coke can. Bird on a post. Football with a broken window. I suppose this could be the football with the broken window.
Nice, bro. No. Nice. Awesome.
This main sprinkler valve looks easy enough to use.
Nice, bro. Except it doesn't.
This main sprinkler valve looks easy enough to use. I must have missed something. I should rewind.
Yeah, I got that.
What the hell? Are you kidding? Look at this.
Chill, Victoria. It's just water.
Yeah, water on my cashmere. Do you know how much this fucking outfit costs?
You look great.
I can't even chill on the steps.
There goes Samuel da Vinci to paint the window.
Yeah. Kate, do you understand English? Get lost.
I think I've missed something. Yeah, but what have I missed? Oh. Tamper with the bucket.
this works.
And then use the sprinkler.
What the hell? Are you kidding? Look at this.
Chill, Victoria. It's just water.
Yeah, water on my cashmere. Do you know how much this fucking outfit costs?
You look great.
I can't even chill on the steps. No way! No fucking
way!
You
okay, Victoria?
Oh, Samuel, sorry. Wet paint is not good for hair, nope. Sorry.
Get the hell away from me, weirdo. Dude.
Hold on. We'll get some towels. We'll be right back.
So move your ass before I dry.
It worked. Don't mess with Max, bitches. Hey, Victoria.
What do you want, Max?
Don't say a word, Max.
Oh, wait. Hold that pose. And no filter needed before I post this.
No.
Now, please move. I've had a messed up day, and I'm going to my room.
You do that? I know where you live. So does Nathan.
Maybe I shouldn't have done that. Now I have to get to my room, then see Warren.
Again, I'm pretty certain last time I didn't do that. Because that's not the sort of thing I'd normally do. I'm playing this different this time. I kind of got to stop being the asshole because I don't like being the asshole.
Red rum. We took so long.
It's pie. It's fry pie.
Home sweet home. My favorite cocoon. It's hard to believe I'm 18 now. I'm lucky my parents enabled my photo habit into adulthood.
Happy birthday, Maxine. We can't believe it's been 18. Oh, okay. Hey, honey, your principal sent me an email saying that he is concerned about your attitude and behavior, that you're not fitting in well and hiding in your dorm. I know it's hard to be away from home, even if you're all grown up now. But if you're there to change the world with your camera, please call me soon. We miss you too. We miss you, Mummy. Wondering if this is one of the songs I know from the soundtrack. Yes, it is. Have fun, Frappy.
Max Caulfield photo memorial wall. Ahoy, Captain. At least I know you've got my back. When I swallowed your eye and my parents rushed me to the ER, I knew we were bonded forever.
That's what I was just playing.
Max and Chloe, best friends forever. Who even says that anymore? I'm going to have to call Chloe eventually and find out what she'll say. The longer I wait, the worse it'll be. Idiot.
You're right.
That's the only tourist picture I let them take of me at the Space Needle.
Right, be right.
That was a good hockey game and a great fight. Man, Kristen and Fernando were so drunk hanging on the Fremont Troll. I look so pathetic. I am so addicted to this site. Look at these vintage beauties. Warren makes me laugh. It's nice to feel like I already made a real friend here. Looks like Dana left me a little post-it note.
Yeah, so she's got the drive.
Great. Now I have to go get the flash drive from Dana's room. One day I'll organize my film collection. One day I'll get an actual HDTV. You are thirsty. I'm the worst baby mama. Drink up. Welcome to the real drama queens of Blackwell.
Oh, Juliet, this is so stupid.
Answer.
Hey, Juliet, is everything cool?
Oh, yes, Max. I've locked Dana in the room because we're cool.
You are ridiculous.
She's your friend.
Friends don't sex with their best friend's boyfriend.
No, probably not. How did you find out?
Why do you care? Why are you even asking me? You never talk. Just zone out with your camera.
That's why I'm talking to you now.
What's my last name?
Watson, maybe?
Juliet Watson. Duh.
I'm flattered.
Okay.
I didn't even think you knew my name at all.
Maybe I'm remembering.
Of course I do. Just because I don't talk a lot doesn't mean I don't care. So, how did you find out about them?
According to Victoria, Dana would do anything to date a quarterback.
According to Victoria? Huh.
She saw the sext, and Zachary won't answer his phone. Once Dana admits it, she can go. Straight to hell.
Max, I swear I didn't do anything, but I bet Victoria did. I know the proof is in her room.
I'm not- Answer, you wuss.
Okay. It can't be set off the fire alarm again.
I should find a way to end this silly standoff.
I forgot who she was trying to call.
me alone, Max. Get a clue.
Whoa, I had no idea Victoria's parents owned the Chase space. Color me impressed. That is a tasty plasma. Maybe I could sneak in and watch Final Fantasy Spirits Within. I don't care what anybody says, that's one of the best sci-fi films ever made. Is she going to get a 3D printer for her dorm room? Maybe I will join her posse. They should call this series aloof. Cold and soulless. Kinda like Victoria. Speaking of selfies, let's play a little photo Tetris and leave Victoria a message. Let's move this here, and this one there. A pattern is emerging.
So how am I going to break the stalemate here? I'm not sure what to do.
I'm not letting her out until she tells the truth.
I should find a way to end this silly standoff.
I can't just keep setting off the fire alarm.
At least that's an alarm from this century. Looks like nobody won this TP war. There's nothing left but ghosts. Oh man, this is so wrong. I better find proof fast. Go, Miss Grant. Not sure if I will, though. I'm a loser.
No need to go there now.
Welcome to Black Hill.
So, I don't know what I'm supposed to do here.
Remember, you're not a criminal. You're a ninja. So move.
What am I supposed to do?
I'm glad Kate let me borrow her copy of The October Country. I should have every Bradbury book for myself. Instant film is so damn hard to find and expensive now.
But I can't help it. I'm analog, not digital. Philip Lorca de Corsia, my man. I don't think I could take my camera to those places. Look at that shot. I love Julia Cameron's Victorian vibe. Talk about analog cameras. Ah, oh, Dolly, what a fantastic eye. He could truly freeze time.
So, it's obvious I'm remembering some things, but not others.
If I'm not looking through a viewfinder, I'm looking through a window. Always looking. I love that Mom sent me a fat box of chocolate coconut bites for my birthday. And slipped in a $200 gift certificate. She sure knows how to make a sad birthday happy. Warren even left me a little message with his flash drive. He's such a goofball.
I'm really confused.
I feel like ass doing this, but I could rewind things if I have to.
Right.
I have to stop before I pass out.
Ridiculous.
Hey, Juliet. Is everything cool?
Oh yes, Max. I've locked Dana in the room because we're cool.
If you don't let me out,
What did she do?
What didn't she do? Dana's been sexting with my boyfriend.
Ouch. How did you find out?
Why do you care? Why are you even asking me? You never talk. Just zone out with your camera.
That's why I'm talking to you now.
What's my last name?
Juliet Watson. Duh.
I'm flattered. I didn't even think you knew my name at all.
Of course I do. Just because I don't talk a lot doesn't mean I don't care. So, how did you find out about them?
According to Victoria, Dana would do anything to date a quarterback.
According to Victoria? Huh.
She saw the sext, and Zachary won't answer his phone. Once Dana admits it, she can go. Straight to hell.
Max, I swear I didn't do anything. But I bet Victoria did. I know the proof is in her room.
Still want to mess up
Let's
those.
Let's play a little photo Tetris and leave Victoria a message. Let's move this here. And this one there. A pattern is emerging. That's real nice, Victoria. And boom, this is the email I need to show Juliet. Now I have to print this fast and get the hell out of here. This better convince Juliet that Dana is innocent. Juliet, read this. Of course. I'm an asshole. I'm sorry, Dana.
You are. And I hope so. You really think I'd mess around with Zachary?
No, but I get stupid jealous. I'm an asshole. I owe you dinner. Still love me?
And you do my laundry.
Thanks, Max. You're like the Blackwell Ninja. Now let's see what Zach has to say about Victoria.
You set me free. Thank you. Warren's flash drive is on my desk.
It was so obvious.
Almost done. Get the flash drive and then I'll go see Warren.
Must protect my precious so Max never has to chase it down again.
That looks like a home pregnancy test.
Max, that's mine. Thank you. You're not helpful. You're just nosy. I think you better go.
Nice, Max. You hurt her feelings by being so damn nosy again. But I could rewind and make it up to her. Hey, Dana.
Seriously, thanks again. I can't believe Juliet locked me in my own room. Real mature.
Dana, I'm not trying to be nosy, but I heard a rumor about you.
What? Who told you I was pregnant?
Nobody important. They just acted like it was bullshit. I just wanted you to know.
It's like a goddamn reality show around here. Can you keep a secret, Max?
Of course.
I was pregnant. Was.
Oh. What about the other?
That'd be Dad. You can catch him on the 40-yard line this Friday. And it's not Zachary.
Sorry to pry. It's not my business. And I won't be at the game Friday. Not much school spirit, I guess.
I like your spirit, Max. Anyway, you better get that flash drive so Warren has an excuse to bug you.
I like Dana. Although she does put out with football jokes, so... I am not wanting to rush through this, and I hope the stream is working well. Hey!
That hurt. Damn, I better rewind.
Alyssa, move your head.
If you insist, Max.
Now that's what I'm talking about. I actually helped somebody. Glad to see our campus is eco-friendly.
Oops. So I got that one as well. So I'm missing a few. This is such a weird game. I love it.
So don't think I'm blind. I see everything here at Blackwell. Do you understand what I'm saying?
No, and leave me alone.
Hey, why don't you leave her alone?
Excuse us, this is official campus business.
Excuse me, you shouldn't be yelling at students or bullying them.
Hey, nobody is bullying anybody. I'm doing my job.
No, you're not.
You're part of the problem, Missy. I will remember this conversation.
Oh, Max, that was great. I think you scared him for once. I have to go, but thank you. It means a lot.
Anytime, Kate. I felt like an everyday hero helping Kate, but now Officer David Dickhead is after me. Maybe I should rewind and mind my own business?
Nope. Max to the max. Apparently I'm the only one streaming Life is Strange at the moment. It is a very old game. Squirrel!
I'm glad I stepped in that time. Can't stand to see people being bullied.
Now, I did have to take a photo of a camper, so I wonder if that's it.
It's not a dirty window unless somebody writes "clean me" on it. I could use this picture for a series on Arcadia Bay Lots.
See? So there's still the bird, the sunset, the squirrel, whatever that is, and a broken skateboard.
Check it out.
And there's Warren. Did he actually buy a used car? Look at Warren in his Wayback Machine. He's a brave man.
What up, Max? How are you?
Here's your flash. Thanks.
No problem. Check out my new wheels.
Cool. Very old school.
1978 to be exact. Now we can go to the drive-in. There's one in Newburgh just 60 miles away.
You're in the wrong time, Warren. But then, so am I.
You okay?
It's been one strange fucking day.
Man, I saw that Victoria didn't take down that pic of you on Facebook. Major bitch move.
No worries, Warren. I took a sweet shot of Victoria I can't wait to share.
Oh, score one for Team Max. It would be so karmic to see her ass clown face all over the interwebs.
I guess she does deserve it for all the shitty things she's done to people here.
So, did you get a chance to check out the movie booty on my flash drive?
Yeah, thanks. You had some cool shit on there, from Akira to Twilight Zone, which seems apropos today.
I consider myself a pop cultural pirate connoisseur.
That does sound better than thief.
Ha ha. Make sure you watch Cannibal Holocaust.
No fucking way will I watch that. My mind is twisted enough.
I laughed my ass off.
So you're sensitive.
Ouch, that sounds awful the way you say it.
Not at all. Sensitive is good, unless you're a pushover. You have hip taste and a quick mind.
Thanks for noticing, Max.
The right girl will too.
If I was lucky. Speaking of hip and fast, we should cruise out in my car to an actual movie this week. But you seem distracted.
I don't want to speak about it. This is kind of a crazy day for me. I mean, I literally think I'm going crazy.
I may be a pest, but I'm a good listener.
For reals, Warren, this is between you and me, not social media.
Don't insult me. Max, go on.
I had this incredibly bizarro experience in Mr. Jefferson's class today. I mean, life-changing. Have you ever had a dream so real it was like a movie?
Max Caulfield, right? You're one of the Jefferson's photo groupies?
I'm one of his students.
What the fuck ever? I know you like to take pictures, especially when you're hiding out in the bathrooms. You best tell me what you saw, now. Answer me, bitch!
What are you talking about?
I know you're new here, but don't even play stupid with me.
I'm not new. I've lived here for years.
Then you should know the Prescotts own this shithole.
Then you don't have to worry about me. Worry about yourself.
Do not analyze me! I pay people for that. Worry about yourself, Max Caulfield.
Take a step back, Nathan Prescott.
Oh man, you're telling me what to do?
Get away from her, dude!
Hey! Leave him alone!
Nobody tells me what to do! Not my parents, not the principal,
that.
Or that whore in the bathroom!
Max? Chloe?
No way. You again.
Warren!
Go! Go! I got this!
Get in, Max!
Get your punk asses out of there now! Don't even try to run! Nobody messes with me! Nobody!
We're not running. We're just sitting.
Man, Nathan Prescott is messed up and dangerous. This day never ends.
Oh, and thanks, Chloe. After 5 years, you're still Max Caulfield. Don't give me the guilty face. At least pretend you're glad to see me.
I am seriously glad to see you.
Me too.
Oh, and thanks, Chloe. It makes perfect sense I'd see you today.
Yes, it's been that kind of day. So what did that freak want with you?
Hopefully nothing after today. So, how do you know Nathan?
He's just another Arcadia asshole. Your friend really took a beat down for you.
Warren? Yeah, I owe him big time.
You're not the only one in debt. And you're already causing trouble.
I thought it would be quiet here. Feels so weird to be back.
So I guess Seattle sucked hard?
No, it felt like a real city for artists. Big and bright. Great for taking pictures.
Yeah, must be hard coming back to a hick town like Arcadia again.
Not after seeing you.
Please, girl. You came back for Blackwell Academy.
Of course, it's one of the best photography programs in the country. And my favorite teacher, Mark Jefferson.
So you came back to Arcadia for a teacher, not your best friend.
Don't you think I'm happy to see you?
No. You were happy to wait 5 years without a call or even a text.
I'm sorry. I know things were tough on you when I left.
How do you know? You weren't even here.
I didn't order my parents to move specifically to fuck you over, Chloe.
You've been at Blackwell for almost a month without letting me know. Enough said.
I just wanted to settle in first and not be such a shy, cliche geek. I totally would have contacted you.
I bet you don't use these sad excuses on Mr. Jefferson. Don't use them on me, Max. you cereal? Wow, haven't heard that one in a while.
Not everything changes. Except my camera has officially taken a shit.
My step douche has a boatload of tools. Maybe you can fix it in my place.
I need very specific tiny tools.
Nerd alert. My stepdad has a fully stocked garage, and he actually is a tiny tool. Welcome home, Max.
I'm very interested in people commenting specifically in the video more than in the chat, so when the video goes live, about what they think of the story beats in this game and everything. Because, man, this is so cool. I'm interested in chat as well, but it's much easier to find the comments after the fact.
Come on in, don't be shy.
The house still. Feel free to comment on the story as we go through and like make suggestions, although there is like a 10-second lag, so... Just no spoilers in the comments or anything. Well, I suppose spoiler warning your comment.
My room looks a bit different than the last time you saw it.
It's cool. At least we can chill out.
This isn't exactly my chill out zone. My step fuhrer makes sure of that. Come in and close the door. Put on some music while I medicate.
Look at that. Chloe and her dad were so close. It won't play without any power. Houston, we have the power, but we need to find a disc to play. I think this junk swallowed her discs. Who'd have thought Chloe wouldn't pay her parking tickets? She does love trouble. We had such a blast drawing these together.
Dude, you broke my glass snow dough. Thank you.
Oh, this is a flashback to youth. Our super secret closet lair. Chloe totally changed her style. I barely recognized her. Chloe was always taller than me. We made her dad keep track of her height.
Rachel?
Hey, give me that!
Sorry, I wasn't trying to be nosy. Obviously, she was a good friend.
It's putting it mildly.
That's Rachel Amber. Her missing person posters are all over Blackwell.
Yeah, I put them up. She was my angel. After my dad died and you moved, I felt abandoned. Rachel saved my life.
Man, I had no idea.
Well, you never made much effort to find out. I was 14. We were best friends.
I never forgot, even if I was an asshole and didn't keep in touch. But you had Rachel.
Rachel had my back. We were gonna kick the world's ass. You would laugh at how different we were. She wanted to be a star.
She looks like a model.
That was her plan. Our plan. Get the hell out of Bigfootville and into Los Angeles.
What about your mom? What did Joyce think about all this?
She couldn't wait to get rehitched.
Joyce.
Step dick is one reason I wanted to bail.
I feel the love. Now, when did Rachel actually disappear?
6 months ago. She just left Arcadia. Without a word. Without me.
How do you know she disappeared? Maybe she wanted to start a totally new life.
Unlike you, she would have told me, okay? Something happened to her.
I believe you. I'm just trying to get all deductive.
Before Rachel left, she said she met somebody who changed her life. And poof.
And you haven't heard anything from her since?
Like everybody in my life. My dad, you, and Rachel. Gone. Can you put on some music now?
I still have a lot of CDs.
Anyway, you can find tools to fix your camera in the garage.
Chloe, are you okay?
Sure, I'm awesome. I just want to blaze and be alone for a moment.
I shouldn't bug Chloe now. Plus, I need those tools.
I tell you, make a dream. 15 kids in his head, break your mind.
You can't go home again, said Thomas Wolfe. But here I am. This is definitely Joyce's makeup. Chloe wouldn't use animal products.
When we left behind.
I wonder if Chloe is taking those pills. I hope she's okay. I like Chloe's new hair color. She's the opposite of shy. Of me. Books have not been touched since the last decade. I see why.
I am really video
this
game.
Must be Chloe's parents' room. Man, I am nosy today.
Yeah, video games make everyone an asshole.
The prices are late on their bills.
The telephone.
Joyce still works at the diner. And Chloe's new dad is a security guard. Uh-oh.
Down the windy on the road.
I could do something to save it.
I'm absolutely saving the bird, though.
Nope. Someone locked it from the other side. Now this is the Chloe I remember. Always smiling and laughing. Not so much anymore.
What did I do to help Kate again? Oh, right. Kind of funny that I get that text here, but you'll find out why later. Although, it's kind of obvious.
I'd love to go to Paris, too. At this rate, they'll be lucky to get to Portland. Joy still works at Two Wells Diner. Best damn burgers in Arcadia.
Man, I could go a burger.
I haven't seen this place in 5 years. Seems like forever. Hey, I remember that stain. Chloe and I knocked over Joyce's wine bottle and we scrubbed forever, but it never came out. We got so busted. Damn, it's the couch. We used to pretend it was a pirate ship. Looks like a shipwreck now. I should be able to find the tools I need here. Chloe's stepdad is head of security at Blackwell. He wants to put surveillance cameras all over the school? How paranoid can you get? Chloe's stepfather is this asshole from Blackwell? You've got to be shitting me. One of these guns is missing. I hope Chloe's stepdad isn't packing heat. Boom, precision screwdrivers. Except I can't reach them. That was very smart, dumbass. No can reach. Yes, you have mad skills, Max. What the? Chloe's stepdad actually installed cameras in the rooms? For reals?
Reals?
This guy has serious trust issues. Do Chloe and Joyce even know about this?
I don't know. So he had to reposition.
No password. Like it would help me find tools anyway.
Well, I've got the tools.
I wonder what's in those files up there. Shit! Butterfingers! No password. Like it would help me find tools anyway. Poor little dear. It's not enough to kill you, they have to display your head.
Why doesn't it surprise me that this guy has a Florida sign?
Look at all that food. That's like enough spam for 100 years.
It's really not.
Check out the muscle car. Chloe's stepdad must be a gearhead.
Actually, I wonder if I could unlock the door.
Cool, now it's opened.
So, I know this is a slow-paced game, but I hope people are enjoying it, because I really am.
You found the tools. Sweet. You can sit at my desk and fix your camera. So?
I can't fix this thing.
Are these your new photos?
Yeah, I just took them today.
Let me see. Booyah, you skank. Karma's a bitch. Nice framing, too. Wait, I've seen this before. No way. When did you take this? You took this photo, you brat? In the bathroom today. You set off the alarm. That's why Nathan raged after you. It totally makes sense. You hella saved my life.
Hella did.
Now tell me the truth, Max.
I was there, hiding in the corner.
Damn, you're a ninja.
A ninja would have cut Nathan's head off. I just took a butterfly photo.
That is so badass.
Oh yeah, I almost wet myself when I saw the gun.
So, did you recognize me?
Nope.
Not at all. Your hair and clothes are so different.
I mean, so.
I did, but I've played this before.
I'm sure this is all so weird to you after coming back.
Like you said, it's been that kind of day.
So you must have overheard our conversation.
Just a bit.
There is no way you didn't hear every single vowel.
Okay, I only heard something about money, drugs, but that's it.
Now for the big question. Did you tell anybody?
No, I didn't know what to do.
I don't blame you. That's some intense shit.
Maybe I should go to the principal.
The principal? Are you still 12? That drunk jackass only cares about cash for Blackwell Academy. Don't trust him.
Seriously, I didn't blab to anybody. Promise.
Thank God. I'll tell you more someday. And I seriously owe you, Max.
I know it was your birthday last month. This was my real father's camera. I want you to have it.
That's so cool you remembered my birthday. But I can't take this.
Of course you can. My dad would be pissed if I never used it, and now I know it'll be used awesomely. And I'll snag this picture as a symbol of our reunion. Cool?
Yes, of course it's cool. Thank you. This camera is so sweet.
Now that we got that mushy shit out of the way, I feel like stage diving. Let's thrash this place.
You're crazy.
Yep, I'm fucking insane in the brain. Let's dance! Shake that bony white ass. Or take my picture with
this game is really different when I know the soundtrack.
This day couldn't get any stranger.
Well, life is strange. Who ever heard that before?
This song fucking rules. Can't dance, hippie? Come on. Rock out, girl. Yes, break it down, Max.
Turn it off.
Oh, it was actually in-game.
Dude, the music's not even on. Asshole.
I'm coming up. We need to talk.
Oh, no fucking way. You need to hide now. My stepdad will kill me if he finds you here.
Chloe, what's going on? Open this door, please.
Chill, I'm changing. Is that okay? Max, find a place to hide now.
Chloe,
I'm coming.
What are you doing? Chloe, you're stalling.
I'm changing. Give me a minute.
Don't get smart. Just let me in. Now. Chloe, you're stalling.
I'm changing. Give me a minute.
Don't get smart. Just let me in. Now. Please.
1 second. My bra is stuck.
I'm not screwing around, soldier. Chloe, open this door.
Shit.
What's going on in here?
Jesus, I'm just trying on clothes. You're so friggin' paranoid.
Yeah, combat will do that to you. One of my guns is missing. Did you take it?
Oh, God, I didn't take your stupid gun. You do know I believe in gun control?
Wait, is that grass? You been toking up again in here?
Oh yeah, guns, weed. You were tripping balls.
I'm sick of your disrespect. Tell me the truth. That's an order. Whose is it?
Stop treating me and my mom like we're your family platoon.
Hey, leave Joyce out of this.
I wish you'd leave Joyce, like now.
Chloe, I'm sorry. I care about your mother, and you just keep pushing me.
Don't touch me again, asshole. That's the last time. Or I'll bring the cops in here so fast.
You're not that dumb.
I'd be smart to have you busted.
Chloe, someday you'll grow up.
Hey, you okay?
Welcome to the real step douches of Arcadia Bay.
I'm sorry.
For what? He would have been a bigger dick if he caught you in here.
That's hard to believe.
Anyway, let's sneak out the window. There is one cool place we can go to in this hick hole.
David was such a mean bastard to Chloe. What if I had stepped up to help?
No. Again, I'm kind of trying to make different choices this time. I don't remember what I did last time, but my... I don't know.
Can you go already? I want to get the hell out of here.
Huh. Lighthouses everywhere. Well, there's only one place where the lighthouse is, but it kind of matters. Man, it's still early. Oh no, it's 9:30.
I haven't been here in forever. So why do I feel like I was just here? Whoa. This is the exact same path I was on during my nightmare today. They haven't updated this sign since the 1980s. People can be such pigs.
It's getting late. If this is the end of chapter one, and I'm fairly certain it's fairly close, because I think chapter one is the shortest chapter, because there's five chapters, and chapter one is the free chapter. Kick.
Birds are so lucky, they can always escape.
So I think I missed the squirrel with the can. I missed the broken skateboard. I missed whatever that is. Possibly these two are here. Maybe not.
I don't remember this at all, but it seems like it's been here for a long time. Wowzer, Chloe drew that to mark our tree fort, so we'd always be able to find each other in case of emergency. Looks like the youth of Arcadia Bay still come up here to party. I never made it. How long has that been here?
Probably since the early 90s.
Clearly, the Bigfoots are everywhere. Too bad it's locked. I remember racing up and down the steps.
I'm not too worried about the missing photos. They're just for achievements. And you can't rewind time too far. If you miss them, you miss them. So there's four I missed. So what?
Sure you don't want to be alone?
And this may not be the end of the chapter.
Are you pissed at me?
I just wanted some backup.
I'm not as brave as you. And David is indeed a step douche.
I'm sorry you had to experience it firsthand.
You have to live with him. Has he always been this way?
Ever since my desperate mom dragged his ass to our home, I never trusted David.
He freaked out on poor Kate Marsh today.
I know her. She's cool. Only that prick would bully her.
He has some kind of weird agenda.
He has a lot of secret files. Rambo still thinks he's gathering enemy intelligence. Did you take a peek?
You know, I wanted to, but I realized I have enough mystery in my life.
I'd like to find out. I bet he's got some serious porn in there.
Ugh.
Good thing you didn't look. He's a total surveillance fetish. Where are there spy cams in the house?
I knew you didn't know. Chloe, your house is under surveillance.
What are you talking about?
There are cameras all over the house. I saw it on a monitor in the garage.
I knew it. He's so hella fucking paranoid. I'll keep this a secret for now.
Sometimes ignorance is bliss.
No wonder I'm so miserable. Everybody in this town knows everybody's secrets.
Even yours?
Not anymore.
So what do you have on Nathan?
He's an elite asshole who sells bad shit cut with laxative. And he dosed me with some drug in his room.
What?
I met him in some shithole bar that didn't card me. He was too rich for the place and too wasted, and he kept flashing bills.
Just tell me what happened, Chloe. Now.
I was an idiot. I thought he was so blazed it would be an easy score.
You needed money that bad?
Actually, yes. I owe big time. And I thought I'd have enough for me and Rachel if she showed up.
So, what about you and Nathan?
We went to his room at Blackwell. We drank, and I laughed at his rich kid bullshit. He was one step ahead and put something in my beer.
God, Chloe. I can't believe this. I mean, I do. Then what?
I know I passed out on the floor. I woke up and that perv was smiling, crawling towards me with a camera.
Go on.
Everything was a blur. I tried to kick him in the balls and broke a lamp. Nathan freaked, so I managed to bum rush the door and get the hell out. Max, it was insane.
Chloe, that is so fucked up. What did you do then?
I figured I would make him pay me to keep quiet. So we met in the bathroom.
And he brought a gun.
That was Nathan's last mistake.
He's still dangerous, Chloe. Not just to you.
Good thing you didn't tell anyone. Nathan Prescott better watch his back now.
I won't always be there to save you.
You were here today, Max. You saved me. I'm still tripping on that. Seeing you after all these years feels like...
destiny.
This is so cool.
If this is destiny, I hope we can find Rachel. I miss her, Max. This shit pit has taken away everyone I've ever loved. I'd like to drop a bomb on Arcadia Bay and turn it to fucking glass.
Oh dear.
Is Chloe still up there? I have to find out.
Storm like this is Oregon. Oh my lord! The
The tornado is back!
So the whole point is to get ahead of it, because I travel back in time, but I maintain my position. Nope, not far enough. Holy cow.
October 11th? Is this Friday? That's only 4 days away. Oh no. The tornado is headed straight for the town. Chloe, you're here. I'm back. Oh my lord, this is real. It's real. Oh man, this sucks.
Max, what's going on? You totally blacked out.
I didn't black out. I had another vision. The town is going to get wiped out by a tornado.
Oregon gets about 5 tornadoes every 20 years. You just zoned.
No, no, I saw it. I could actually feel the electricity in the air.
Come on, take a breath, okay?
Chloe, I'm not crazy. But there's something else I have to tell you. Something hardcore.
Talk to me, Max.
I had this same vision earlier in class. When I came out of it, I discovered I could reverse time. Like I said, not crazy.
But high? Right?
Listen to me. How do you think I saved you in the bathroom?
By reversing time? Yeah, sure.
I saw you get shot, Chloe. Saw you actually die. I was able to go back and hit the fire alarm.
Okay, I see you're a geek now with a great imagination, but this isn't anime or a video game. People don't have those powers, Max.
I don't know what I have, but I have it. And I'm scared shitless.
You need to get high. It's been a hell insane fucking day. What the hell is this?
Snowflakes?
It's like 80 degrees. How?
Climate change. Or a storm is coming.
Max, start from the beginning. Tell me everything.
Well, you could just watch the last 2 hours of the stream and then you'll be up to date. Considering they gave away chapter 1 for free and then sold chapters 2 through 5, doing this montage at the end so that you could see the other characters and the other locations, I thought was beautiful. So that's episode 1. That was absolutely amazing. I really enjoyed that. Playing this again and encountering the characters, I'm remembering a lot of the character stories and everything. I'm pretty certain that episode 1 or chapter 1 is the shortest of all of them. remembering some of the story beats, which is fine. I'm really enjoying going through it again. It's like reading a book that you love, except I'm able to make different choices and see different things. The main story beat's going to be the same. It's not going to be like Cyberpunk 2077, where the different story beats are going to completely change the ending. But since I started streaming again, this game has been high on my list, and there are other games in the series. There's Life is Strange Before the Storm, which is set before this game. It's a prequel. There is Life is Strange True Colors, which I don't know anything about, and there's Life is Strange 2, which I've heard is a completely different set of characters. So all of those are going to go on my bucket list. I've already owned Life is Strange Before the Storm. My goal over this long weekend, I've got 5 days off, is to record a bunch of puzzles and to play Life is Strange, because this is great. I hope people enjoy this. I'd be very interested to see comments about what you think about me playing this style of game, but mild spoiler, I remember crying playing this game. So we'll see how we go. Thank you everyone for watching. I hope you have enjoyed this stream. It's been 2 hours, and this seems like a really good place to stop. And tomorrow morning I'm probably going to be back, because it's 5 chapters. If I can do that in 5 streams, that would be great, but I'm not going to force myself. If I start getting tired or I think I've been doing enough, I'll stop in the middle of a chapter. That's fine. I do highly recommend the soundtrack. If you've got YouTube Premium, I'm pretty certain it is available on the YouTube music service. It's probably on Spotify. I just bought the soundtrack. It is very, very good. Thank you everyone. I will come out. So, oh, and this is a summary. So, and it tells you what people did. So I hid the truth, which 38% of people do. I made fun of Victoria, which only 26% of people do. I intervened to help out Kate, which is the most common thing. And I stayed hidden. Blaming Chloe is an option. Wow. Staying hidden is the most common option. Oh, I don't want to start chapter 2. Okay. So I don't want to start chapter 2. So I'm going to exit to main menu. So thank you everyone. This has been absolutely amazing. No, that's fine, Keith. This is why I'm streaming on YouTube, because then the VODs are kept. I hope I was vocal enough, but I just hope people enjoy me playing the game and enjoy watching the game. I'm trying not to interrupt the story too much, but I'm still trying to be me while playing it. Thank you everyone. And as always, I don't know, good luck dealing with the strange that is life. Bye everyone.